What's up, everybody? This is Drew's for an Xbox Live, welcoming you to my playthrough of Super Ultra Dead Rising 3 Arcade Remix Hyper Edition EX Plus Alpha. So far, I've been progressing through it with all the Nick characters. I've unlocked a couple more out here, obviously. I'm going to try it with this one. See what we got going on here. So last time I was playing through it, I was trying to get through Sunset Hills and wasn't working out too well for me, so I'm going to try it again. Now with this character instead of Tuxedo Nick, because as you progress through the different available Round character types, different stats go up, so hopefully.
I'm ready.
Ready, go!
Hopefully, this one will be able to actually progress further than Tuxedo Nick was, because I could never get past round four on Sunset Hills with Tuxedo Nick. Every time I tried, I would always fail right at part four. So, after a while of trying, I just decided to stop. Alright, you know what? Screw you. Here, keep that.
Maximum health. Clear. Wins. Perfect. Thank you.
So far, of all the survivor rescue missions, this one is definitely my least favorite. This one is really tricky too. Like, I always have stuff like that happen. Gotta be kind of careful on this part here, because if you don't fall just right, you can actually, dang it, fall off like that. Thank you. gotta make this work, because I won't have enough time to do it again. Dang it! If I get this, I'll be very lucky. I hope I get it, because I don't want to have to start all over again. Damn it, I'm not gonna get it. Son of a bitch. I hate this survivor.
Time's up. You lose.
Now I have to do the whole thing again. I really don't know why they put a survivor up there. It's stupid. It's absolutely stupid. That fall is so stupid because there's nothing you can do. Unless you fall just right, there's nothing you can do because every time you drop down, Nick doesn't just stop. He always moves a little bit further after the fall. So you have to fall in a spot where you're not going to walk off the edge, which, as you clearly just saw, is a pain. And now I have to go all the way back to round one and start again. Luckily, this time it happened on, like, round two. Last couple times I made it to round four and had to start over again. Either way, it kind of frustrates me because I spent, like, an hour or two earlier today trying to get through this map. And never made it past round four, and now here I am just trying to get through it again. And now I can't even get through round two. So hopefully we'll have some better luck this time.
Let's begin.
Ready, go!
Awesome. I love the sensitivity of the driving on this game. So cute.
Destroy the target.
I think this time I'm actually going to try and go for that harder survivor first. I normally like to go for the other ones because they're right there anyway, and you're going to run past them trying to get to the other ones. But I think I might just go ahead and I'll scoop up the ones that are like right by me. Like the three that are right by me at the start, I'll scoop up, but then I think I'm just going to go for that problem one. I'm going to go for that problem survivor right after that. Much better that time. Much better. gonna give a shout out to Fearful Dreams. What up, man? How you doing?
Perfect.
Let me move my laptop so that when you guys type stuff, I can see it easier.
Round four.
I'm ready.
Ready, go!
Yeah, no problem, Fearful. Thanks for watching, man. I appreciate it. Yeah, I actually have all the DLC for this game. All of them except this one were in the season pass. This one was $10. I actually ended up picking it up with Microsoft credit because I'm in the VIP reward program. And I happened to rack up $10, so that's what I got it with. But all of them are really cool. The other DLC you get with it are called the Untold Stories, and they're all included in the season pass. There's four of them. Those included with this, it's a total of like 115 achievements, and I don't know off the top of my head the exact amount of gamer score, but it's a lot. This DLC alone added 500 gamer score.
Thank you.
It's something you sign up with through Microsoft for with Xbox Live Gold, but basically, when you buy certain games or play certain downloadable content or do certain things that Xbox is promoting, they reward you with rewards points, and typically they won't deposit the rewards into your account until you're at 5,000 points. You can request an early deposit after you have 1,000. And I never even paid attention to it. I just happened to notice that there was $10 in my account from that. So, yes, this DLC does have multiplayer. The main game also has multiplayer, but not as good, not as many multiplayer. The main game has two-player co-op, and this DLC has four-player co-op. So, TV's kind of loud. Hold on, I'm kind of shouting over my TV. All right, here we go. Now I can hear better. So, yeah, in the main game, you have two-player co-op, and then in this particular DLC, you have four-player co-op. Each player can choose between Nick, Annie, Chuck, and Frank, and then there's different characters that you can unlock with each one. So like this character I'm playing as right now, Edward Falcon, is actually one of Nick's unlockable characters. Yeah, the main game's good. There's only one achievement I have left for the main game, and that's Prestige Hound, because when I got all the rest of them done, there were other games I was trying to play, and so Dead Rising kind of got pushed to the back burner. But then when this DLC came out, I picked it back up, and it's fun. I really like it a lot. I love Dead Rising anyway, but this DLC is actually really... This whole game is just awesome. Hold on a second. I'll answer some more questions here in a second. I want to focus on this, so I'm not looking at the monitor right now. This is actually the furthest I've gotten so far in Sunset Hills. Yeah, the Mega Man suit's really cool. I actually unlocked it as well. You unlock it in two stages. You unlock the suit first, and then you unlock the gun second. I unlocked the Mega Man outfit. I just never actually have worn it yet. I mostly play with the Surf Bot mask on and the tuxedo because I'm a nerd. Shadow boss? Oh no. I have no idea what this guy's like. I've never made it this far before. See if I can get some armor. Oh no! What's up, Drinkable? Oh, shoot, I should pick up my rewards, huh? I'm all watching the monitor to see what you guys are saying, and I'm not paying attention. There we go.
Duncan wins.
Oh, another achievement. What is it? Suburbia. Oh, it's probably for completing Sunset Hills. I'm playing Dead Rising. What does it look like I'm doing? This is the Super Ultra Dead Rising 3 Arcade Remix Hyper Edition EX Plus Alpha that they released with E3 conference.
Right.
Woohoo! S rank. I think that's like the second S rank I've gotten. There's an achievement for S ranking all of the districts.